house.
Amen.
Amen. Well, you've got looking for a blessing.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God today. I tell you what, those were some beautiful songs there. Both of them was. I enjoyed it. I love to hear good songs, especially when y'all fire that the Darwin says on Andy Griffith. I like to hear the Darwins on there. When they can't sing, they ain't got much grit. They ready. And they all get in it. That's the way these women were this morning. Now they got in it. They poured their heart out to it. And I appreciate that. I really do. We're going to have to get Miss Carolyn back into singing them. She don't mind much. It blessed me to hear her sing. I blessed my wife to hear her sing. And others, you know. And that's the reason I'm here. I ain't here to be blessed. I'm here to lift up Jesus' name. And that's what we all are doing. When you singing and praising God, that's what you're doing. You're lifting up His name. And somebody's getting a blessing out of it. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So if you got your Bibles this morning, turn over to the book of Acts chapter 19. Acts chapter 19. I'm just going to read a couple of verses, and I'm just going to read one verse right here. I'm going to read verse 17. And this was known to all the Jews and Greeks, also dwelling in Ephesus, and fear fell on them all, and the name of the Lord Jesus was magnified. Let's go to the Lord. Father, we love you this morning, and I appreciate you so much, precious God. Father, thank you again for each one that's here this morning. God, thank you for those that's not here this morning, that's out. God, I ask you to be with them in a special way. I ask you to touch them if one of them is sick, God, to restore their health, Lord, too, God, this morning, according to your will. Lord, in these that's on our prayer list this morning, you know their needs, God, and I ask you to meet those needs too, Father, according to your will. Be with those unspoken requests, God. You know their needs, and I ask you to meet them too, Father, according to your will. Lord, in these names that's in the box up here, you know each and every one of them personally, God. And I ask you to meet these needs too, Father, according to your will, Lord. Be with our Sunday school teacher this morning, God, just give her the words to teach us. Morning, God, that these young and precious Lord, down through the years, Lord, remember the word, God. I love you, Father. I ask you to continue to teach me your word, Lord. You know that I don't have all the words this morning, but I know that you do, God. You said from the start, when you said, I'll be with you everywhere you go. I know you hear this morning, Lord. I ask you to use me in a mighty way, Father, in Jesus. Amen. Oh, I love you this morning. In this passage here, this is Paul's third missionary journey, Brother Bill. Headed out here, and he's going to a place where there's just heathen people, and they don't know the Lord. They're serving idols, serving different things that they made up. That's a shame today. You see people today, even today, they got things that they make up that they serve the true and living God.
That's right.
And these here today, Paul goes there, and he's been preaching and teaching, and he is headed there, and he has brought out a wonderful ministry here. He has reached people here. And in studying this, you see back up, he even wrote in here, he visited the Corinthians, Galatians, and all of them. He has established all these churches. But his mightiest work was done right here in this place here. When he first went there, he asked him, have you been saved, you know? Why have you been saved? And all the thing that they had been taught and preached to was the baptism of John. Well, he begins to tell them about it. Well, and he tells them in this passage there, well, John truly baptized you into repentance, but there was supposed to be one coming after him that will fill you with the Spirit, with the sweet Holy Spirit. Well, they didn't know nothing about this. John, we know, but as far as it's coming, we do not know. And Paul began to preach to them and to tell them about Jesus Christ. Brothers and sisters, today we need to tell people today about Jesus Christ, because there are people today that's right here in this town of Waynesboro, Mississippi, that do not know Jesus Christ as their Savior. Is all they know is they probably have heard something. Well, what about it? They don't know it. Brothers and sisters, today we better tell people about Jesus Christ. They want to hear things. Some of them going on different things, taking different routes, because they're not satisfied with that they are hearing and seeing. They try it on.
That's right.
Brothers and sisters, we've got to get the Word of God out. And that's what Paul was done. Paul's heart was touched when God saved him. He wanted to save the whole world, Brother Bill, but he couldn't get to every place, Sister Dolly, at one time. He wanted to tell them how much Jesus loved them, how much Jesus paid the price for them, how he died on the cross for them. That was his main mission. The cross was his main mission. He wanted to get that out to them. Oh, that's what we need to do today. You go to church today and you start preaching to people and tell them about the love of Jesus and how he went to the cross and how he died on the cross, how he taken your sin back. They don't want to hear it, Brother Bill. They don't want to hear that. They want to hear something sweet. But let me tell you what. Jesus paid the price on the cross to where I could be free today. Free! Free from sin! That's what I'm talking about, brothers and sisters. Free from the bondage of sin.
Amen.
And thank God for that. There's a song for some. I'm looking forward one day to being in that place where I can walk the streets of gold and talk to different ones there, because I've got loved ones that have done gone, those in there, and enjoying the presence of God.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, I'm going to enjoy the presence of God one day, because I've done made my mind up, Brother Bill, that I'm going to heaven regardless of what the devil puts in front of me or what he does. My mind is made up, and as long as I keep my eyes focused on Jesus, I'm going to walk through the gates of pearl.
Amen.
Praise God. That's what we want to do, ain't it, Brother Rudy?
Amen.
It'd be all right to leave today. That's the way I feel tonight. I ain't going to miss them. It's going to be too wonderful up there. Things are going to be too nice. But anyhow, Paul is pouring his heart out to them. He's telling them like it is. You've got to repent. You've got to have Jesus, that sweet Spirit in you, dwelling in you and guiding you. And then the Bible tells us that they, many of them, believed. And they turned to Jesus Christ and began to follow him. Then look what happens in here. Then the priests in here and different ones in here, they get upset. Look what they're trying to do. They are against it. They stop Paul from preaching in there. And Paul rents a place out here in a school, it says. He rented a place there in the middle of the day that he could go there there for over 2 years preaching the Word of God. Let me tell you what, we need to preach the Word of God. And how did it all come? How did Jesus pay the price? How what He's done? Praise God, and He comes in there and He tells us to there. Paul was a tent maker, you remember. How did Paul work hard? He worked and prepared his way. He earned money by working. And the climate they was in over there was a hot climate. Sort of like we've been having here. You get outside, Brother Rudy, and you'll get hot. You'll start sweating. And that's what Paul was doing. He was sweating, and the Bible says that God began to do mighty works with Paul. What mighty works did he do other than winning these people to Christ? That was a mighty work. But he didn't stop there. And as he was working, Brother Bill, the Bible says he had a handkerchief. And really what they was calling them was sweat cloths. You get to working out there, and you wipe the sweat off your pride, off your body, and it gets wet. And you throw it down, or lay it over here and let it dry, because it gets soaking wet. Well, Paul would do this. Undoubtedly, he had several. And he would wipe and he'd throw it, and he'd throw it down. Somebody would come along probably and need that piece of rag probably to fill up a patch on the clothes or something and said, well, I can use that at the house. That person might have been sick, but anyhow, the Bible said when they picked it up, every what kind of disease they had, what, brothers and sisters, look what God uses. He can use the dirtiest things in Him to bring Him the glory and the praise. Praise God.
Amen.
It is just a no dirty wet cloth. And the Bible says that there were several. They begin to watch Him. And as He throws these down, they would come by and pick up these here. And ever what disease he had, the Bible said, he was healed of. Brothers and sisters, today, let me tell you what. I remember years ago, some of y'all probably knew too, that they would send out a handkerchief, a prayer handkerchief. We have prayed over this. You send me $100. And I guarantee you, you're going to receive count $1,000. You just spend me $100 and it's to give you and you lay it on your head. Brothers and sisters, today, Paul didn't charge one dime for those that he threw away.
That's right.
And God ain't going to charge nobody for a healing today. Is all we got to do is believe. Is believe. And one picked it up. And then another picked it up. And they were probably around, Brother Bill. Before it hit the ground, you and some of them would grab it. That's mine. I want to be healed, whatever, what I got. Brothers and sisters, today, there's one thing about it. Jesus Christ ain't changed one bit today. He's still the same. He's still the same. It's all you got to do is ask and believe. Praise God today. That's what Paul done. He listened to what God had to say. And that's what we have to do. We have to listen to what He says and to trust Him. Trust Him. And the third thing is to obey Him. Brothers and sisters, let me tell you this. We got to obey Him or we will never sleep in glory of heaven.
Amen.
We got to obey Him. Praise God. I done got warning with Brother Bill. Oh, praise God. But anyhow, and he comes in there, and all these here things that they have, and it tells you down in there they had all these books and stuff that they was other heathens and all of that. How did they worship them and everything? And they brought these books, and they had a great big bonfire for them. They turned it all to Jesus. That's what we have to do sometimes. We gather up all this stuff that's bothering us. This is hindering us. This is we tossing around in a sack. Let's lay it down at the foot of Jesus and say, look, here it is. I'm tired of it. You take it, Lord, and do away with it. Let me tell you what. He will do away with it.
Amen.
Just like the little demonstration they call out Sunday Carolyn and this fellow. How did he let her be God's? How did he told her to hold on to her? She never let go. That's the way we are with Jesus Christ, brothers and sisters.
Amen.
We're going to hold on to her. We better not let go. We're too close to the end, Sister Carolyn, to call it quits. We're too close to the end. I don't care if it's 20 years from now, or if it's just the same. We're too close to call it quits. Jesus can appear any time. When he appears, what is he going to be doing? He's going to be looking for his church. This is the church.
Amen.
This old building here is going to burn up, ain't it, Brother Bill?
That's right.
It's going to be taken care of. God said, I got my church. Got my church. I'm going to take care of my church. I'm trusting him today because he is my Savior. He is my Savior.
Amen.
You love him today.
Amen.
You love him. Trust him. If you got anything that you want to leave with him, let me say this. He can take care of you. Yeah, thank you. He's the only one who can. I can't, Brother Bill can. But we can tell you how to get to someone to leave the book. His name is Jesus.
Amen.
Yeah, thank you. And he'd be glad to. Can't you see him with his arms out? Got a big smile on his face. Come on. I'll tell you. I'm tired of you coming in around. I won't. I know what to do with it, see? Because I done paid for it. It's paid for it. That's what he wants to do. Brother Bill, would you do it?
There's no way to describe, you know, we can't imagine how it's going to be in heaven in the presence of God. But let me encourage you to enjoy the presence of God while you're here. We won't be in the physical presence of him, but you'll be in the spiritual presence of him right here. And you can do that. And like the brother said, if you got anything, you turn it over to him. Once you turn it over to him, you don't need to be a messenger no more. He don't need your help. He can take care of it. He didn't need your help to start with to take care of it. All he wants you to do is give it to him and trust him. And then what the brother say? You got to obey him. A lot of times, what we don't get prayers answered because we're not obedient. We don't want to let go of that Bible, do we? That's one reason. Y'all join me at the altar.